You guys look nice, if I could see you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, everyone. How you doing?
Good.
Doing great? Have you ever gotten to meet, like, see someone who is a legend, and you're like, oh, you're in awe of them? That happened to me tonight. And I want to say that you would be hard-pressed to find someone anywhere in the world, really, who does not know the name and reputation of James Earl Jones. Or, second applause, who can't come up with an impression of one of his famous lines. Should I do it? I am your father. Don! Actually, he came up to me and he said, Don, I am not your father. And I said, damn. I would love for you to be my dad. But I actually impersonate him every single day on CNN as I was doing the thing that he made famous. When I say, I'm Don Lemon, and this is CNN. As I was taping that, I was channeling James Earl Jones, right? I cannot be more honored to be here at this time, in this moment, to honor and celebrate the one and only Mr. James Earl Jones. Not only has he been an inspiration to me personally, of course, I work for the network, I am CNN, he's the voice of CNN. He's been an inspiration to me personally, but as a performer, he has broken new ground and broken down old barriers on so many levels, in film, in television, on the stage, and indeed, in his personal life. So in keeping with his legacy, it is only fitting that the Voice Arts Award is also breaking new ground by being the first to truly acknowledge the spoken word in all its facets. Its power to entertain, to make us think, to take action, or to purchase the simple commodities that sustain our daily lives. James Earl Jones's voice has been there, helping to narrate the course of our human culture. So here's just a small taste of it.
Action.
Lucas had never intended to use the on-set vocal performance of David Prowse.
Start tearing this ship apart piece by piece until you find those tapes. Find the passengers of this vessel. I want them alive!
Prowse's voice would later be replaced with a more menacing performance, provided by classically trained stage and film actor James Earl Jones.
George had hired David Prowse, but he said he wanted a so-called darker voice. And not in terms of ethnic, but in terms of timbre. And the rumor is that he thought of Orson Welles, and then probably thought that Orson might be too recognizable. So what he ends up is picking a voice that was born in Mississippi, raised in Michigan, and was a stutterer. And that happened to be my voice.
If this is a consular ship, where is the ambassador? Commander, tear this ship apart until you found those plans and bring me the passengers. I want them alive.
People will come, Ray. They'll come to Iowa for reasons they can't even fathom. They'll turn up your driveway, not knowing for sure why they're doing it. They'll arrive at your door as innocent as children, longing for the past.
Oh. People will come, Ray. People will most definitely come.
G. H. I.
Rude am I in my speech, and little blessed with the soft phrase of peace. For since these arms of mine had 7 years' pith, they have used their dearest action in the tented field. And little of this great world can I speak, more than pertains to feats of broil and battle.
And the raven, never flitting, still is sitting on the pallid bust of Pallas just above my chamber door. And his eyes have all the seeming of a demon's that is dreaming, and the lamplight o'er him streaming throws his shadow on the floor.
Ryan is a total hottie McHotterson.
Are they? He's amazeballs. He's like the hottest hottie that ever hottied.
He's like a hottie times infinity plus another infinity. And his smile is totes adorbs.
Totes my goats. It's cray cray adorbs.
Totes my goats.
Of all the planets in our universe, there is only one that we know can support life. It's called Earth. Disney Nature Films proudly presents a BBC, Greenlight Media, and Discovery Channel production of an extraordinary motion picture event about 1 year in the life of the creatures who share our planet. One day, Simba, the sun will set on my time here and will rise with you as the new king.
And this will all be mine?
Everything. Everything you see exists together in a delicate balance. As king, you need to understand that balance and respect all the creatures, from the crawling ant to the leaping antelope.
But Dad, don't we eat the antelope?
Yes, Simba, but let me explain. When we die, our bodies become the grass, and the antelope eat the grass. And so, we are all connected in the great circle of life.
This is CNN.
Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the Society of Voice Arts and Sciences, it is my distinct pleasure to present this award. Yes, everyone, this is James Earl Jones!
I've always wanted to meet Don Lemon. I dressed up in my turtleneck sweater and came all the way here to Queens to meet Don Lemon. Anybody out there from You Can't Take It With You? This is what a commencement is really like. Okay? The Voice Arts Awards is unique in its acknowledgement of the artistry and the craft that is so important in voice work. On behalf of those unseen performers, whether they're well-known or not so well-known, who apply their craft every day to their work, I accept this award with humility and gratitude. Thank you very much.